That's, are you following him?
That's typical Kendrick, like, flow, that soft, like, talking type of rap. I like that.
But are you following him?
What does he know?
I don't know, but it's like, I don't care if you don't know nothing. That line is hard.
I don't care if you don't know anything. I don't because care if you just said
he
that.
He basically just said, Drake is, yo, you just lying about everything. I know there was like 20 bars that I just did not understand. Mm-hmm. But this one? This one right here?
Be right here, bro.
My head already hurts. That was a triple entendre.
That was. What?
That's a gift for me. Heard it on the podcast. Yeah, listen one more time for the thing. It's gotta be true. They told me the spirit of Machiavelli is alive. And they nigga under 5'5", so it's gotta be you. You asked for the smoke. Now I seen you too busy for the smoke. I won't lie, the people confused. Now you about to get this shit another week and fall back to home, girl. But running up is up. I would've refused. For this industry, but let's shoot a torch at the House of Blues. And now you gotta do some dirty work. You know how to move, right? Right? I know you've never been to jail or putting you, but now we gotta wait a fucking week, cause Taylor Swift is your new top, and if you about to drop, she gotta approve. Bro, Taylor Swift is your new top, and if you wanna drop, she gotta approve. Cause the album came out, and she... Girl, really about to make you act like you not in a feud, or you not as enthused. How are you not in the booth? It feel like you kinda removed. You tryna let this shit die down, nah. Not this time, nigga, you following through. Definitely involved, y'all getting it too. Soon as you get the courage to drop, I'm out on the loose. On the loose. Yeah. Alright. My bad, Mike.
No, you good.
My
you
bad,
good.
Mike. I had to, cause we did not do a video to this. And they about to take it down, so I had to do it one last time. Cause I'm not gonna play the whole song on here, cause they're probably not gonna let us post it.
That was really crazy how he put their voices in there.
Like, oh yeah, nah.
Technology's nuts.
And there was hating on that, but I feel like it's just creativity at its finest. Nobody's ever done it before.
It's a lot of copyright, but yes.
Matt, I mean,
Buddy is not alive to say I do want that.
That to the side. Like I said. Mad creative points from my point of view. Didn't really sound like Tupac, but we got what it was. It was Drake being Drake at his finest, being a petty individual. But that's not what we're here for today. That's not what we're here for today. Because this came out a week ago, and we got some different ago. Shit. I knew you was. I was waiting on you to say it. I gave you the time to say it. Anyways,
shout out to Bobby Smurda.
About a week ago, Fuck whatever, you know, we good. Anyways, it is a new day. And guess what happened yesterday? Or the day before?
Kendrick Lamar
was
came
it yesterday?
Out with something.
I think it was yesterday.
Yes.
It was exactly yesterday.
Day before yesterday.
Well, by the time this video comes out, it probably would have been like 3 days ago.
Yeah.
But that's neither here nor there. What is here right now is the lyrics to the song that we've all been waiting for.
Euphoria. Oh, that's pretty fitting.
You know what's so crazy? It's the name of the home base, Euphoria. Yes. The Instagram will be down below. You guys go make sure you check out some videos from there from different celebrities that we got
to
chat.
Euphoria.
Yep, John T. Euphoria. Different celebrities we got a chance to work with, like JT,
Paul Greasy,
Trina, you know, just to name a few.
Oh, you said JT already.
Tommy Lee, Young Miami coming. You know, it's just light. It's light. It's nothing major.
It's pretty major.
Anyway,
but they ain't gotta know that.
It's another day at the office.
Facts.
Anyways, the track is named Euphoria. If my memory serves correctly, the definition of euphoria is
like bliss.
Blissful happiness,
mm-hmm.
Or a change in your mood.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? In a positive sense.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Drake has a show on Netflix that he helped produce called Euphoria.
Oh, interesting.
You've never heard about that?
I've heard about it. Maybe I've seen it.
Yeah, I watched like one episode. It was the last episode. And the ironic part is,
episode you saw was the last one.
Here, listen to my story, Mike. I came to my ex girlfriend's house while we were still like ex, just to get some ex sex. Just to get some ex, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, you came to came.
Yeah, came real hard. Anyways, you know what I'm saying? We was in the pre-sex mood. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Trying to, you know, buckle down, you know. She was watching Euphoria. I'm like, what is this? It's Euphoria. This is a big show. Drake sponsored. I'm like, Drake? All right, let me see what
Drake?
Right. Well, let me see what the fuck this show working with. Nothing but white people. Okay. First of all, it was this one Spanish kid, I think, at the end. He was just wilding. Like, this, he couldn't have been more than 13, 14 years old. But he's in a full-on shootout with the cops inside of this apartment building. Yeah, I missed so much. Like I said, it was the last episode. I don't know what's going on.
You definitely missed the whole
Yeah. That shit was, boy, was wilding. That happened it was a stage play type of business where it's like, you know, high school drama mm-hmm. incorporated into the arts of, you know, acting.
So you pretty much made Degrassi in 2024.
Wow. That's so, I haven't watched a single episode of Degrassi though.
Really? Ever. You're not missing none.
Anyways, fast forward to today. This is real life. This is real life happening right here. Yes. You know, I'm so sure I'm not going to understand half of what Kendrick is saying. But I told myself I would not even try to figure it out until today.
He needs to really do something, because that last, he got killed.
Yeah, it's two disses on his head. It's two disses on his head. You heard the last one. Yeah. You didn't seem too impressed with the last one. It was crazy to me because I love that song. The beat choice on Taylor Made is Drake to a T. Not understanding why you wasn't bobbing your head to that.
Yeah, I mean, I was bobbing my head. But, like, you know, with me, when it comes to music, you know, I'm very, very upbeat. Lit music, you know what I mean? I'm not even worried about what they talk about.
You want niggas getting murdered and killed.
Selling some drugs.
which is fine. But you know, that is the type of hip hop I fell in love with. That's mm-hmm. why like to me the diss wasn't even that hard. Taylor Made I'm talking about.
Yeah.
The diss wasn't even that hard. It's just it just sounded so classical.
It's very old school.
And it's so Drake. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? People that know Drake for the lyricist that he is knows that that's a beat that he would ride. And he rolled that bitch. Mm-hmm. Now, this quality, you know, he was just really being really petty, which is still like, you know what I'm saying? It's really petty when you bring up two of your idols in AI form.
Facts.
To diss you when one of them is dead. Like, it's like,
yeah,
so much disrespect going on there.
I wonder what Snoop Dogg said about it. He alive?
Now Snoop Dogg's reaction was more like,
give me some money. Pay me.
Don't care. That's none of that. Yeah. Now, Snoop Dogg is really not tripping. There was a video of him in his bedroom. I think he was laying down.
Listening to it?
He wasn't even listening to it. It was kind of like a response type of deal where he didn't say nothing. Right? It was just kind of like, what's going on out here?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Totally unbothered. Tupac's camp?
They pissed off.
Very bothered. They not having. That's why we're not even gonna waste time reacting to it, because it's gonna get taken down anyways.
Yeah.
But this is something that we can react to. Before we get to that though, it's your boy Lex back again, rapper, producer, digital marketer extraordinaire, videographer, whatever you need, we got it here at Legendary TV, and I'm here with my pro. Professional athlete, soon to be world champ in the making, the extraordinary, the man, the myth, the legend himself.
Give me the praise emojis. Woo! Yay! Clap! We didn't do that one more time, but it's fine. We back again one more time for another one. This man just so excited about the song.
I'm so excited.
But yeah, man,
You guys don't understand.
We got another reaction for you guys today, and I'm sorry if my energy is not as, hi, I have another show coming up. I know I just got off another one. Like, Mike, why are you doing another show? Just got off another one, right? We won the pro card there, and then we're going for another pro card, because why not just have them all? So, so yeah, we're going to be reacting to this video, and I'm excited for this one because the last one was, like I said, Kendrick got dragged. So I'm hoping he can do something. It seems like Drake is not stopping. So I think he need to come out at least 3 more songs before.
All right. We pulled up the lyric version because it's Kendrick Lamar we're dealing with here. So we need all the help we can get.
For sure.
Trying to understand what the fuck is going on in here. Exactly. But without further ado, Euphoria, Kendrick Lamar, Drake this.
Woo, shit, my pants, see me do that.
Euphoria. Them superpowers get neutralized. I can only watch in silence. The famous actor we once knew is looking paranoid and now spiraling. You're moving just like a degenerate. Every antic is feeling distasteful. Why calculate you're not as calculated? I can even predict your angle. Fabricating stories on the family front, cause you heard Mr. Morale. A pathetic master manipulator, I can smell the tales on you now. You're not a rap artist, you're a scam artist with the hopes of being accepted. Tommy Hilfiger stood out, but FUBU never had been your collection.
Hold up. That's, are you following him?
That's typical Kendrick, like, flow, that soft, like, talking type of rap. I like that.
But are you following him?
I am following him.
This nigga is breaking down Drake's whole character.
Yeah.
You know what's so crazy? Somebody gave me a hint as to what Kendrick Lamar was trying to convey in his diss. They literally said he's literally telling us everything we know about Drake, mm-hmm. but like so saucy.
Yeah, he's saying that you ain't rap, bro. Like,
yeah, he's saying his whole persona is fabricated.
Yeah,
you know, he's a con artist. You know, and the Tommy Hilfiger and the FUBU lie is kind of a jab at his blackness.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's like...
He wasn't around. We was rocking FUBU and Dickie and all that stuff, you know what I mean?
Watching Hilfiger. And it's crazy because we already know, it's facts. We know what Drake is doing.
Yes.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Even though we know what he's doing, we accept it. Which was all a part of his plan.
Yeah, I mean, we make jokes about, you know, Wheelchair Jimmy and Aubrey and all that stuff. But, I mean, you can't deny that this man is...
That just... knows what he's doing. Yeah, yeah. The fact... And it's just... It blows my mind, right? Because it just speaks to Kendrick Lamar's rap ability to be able to break that down into a song.
Like a story type song thing. Like, yeah.
This is already hot. And he's still talking in his bedtime voice. It's crazy to me. Let's just run a little bit.
It's bedtime.
Yeah.
A pathetic master manipulator, I can smell the tales on you now. You're not a rap artist, you're a scam artist with the hopes of being accepted. Tommy Hilfiger stood out, but FUBU never had been your collection. I make music that electrify him. You make music that pacify him. I can double down on that line, but spare you this time. That's random acts of kindness. Know you're a master manipulator and a bitch, you a liar too. But don't tell no lie about me. And I won't tell truths about you.
What does he know?
I don't know, but it's like, I don't care if you don't know nothing. That line is hard.
I don't care if you don't know anything. Because you just said
he basically just said, Drake is, yo, you just lying about everything.
Yeah.
Everything. And your whole identity is a lie.
And I, you know, I kind of believe that a little bit. Because...
Because
of
what?
Just because of, like, how do you go from one extreme... to a whole nother one. How do you go from Wheelchair Jimmy to now you talking about you got people with guns and all this stuff, and like, was that always who you were and you were just acting at that point? You know what I mean?
No,
like,
he definitely came from Wheelchair Jimmy, right? Mm-hmm. But don't nobody knows what happens behind the closed doors of fame.
Facts.
So it's like, you can say anything. Mm-hmm. And Kendrick Lamar is saying he's been using that to his advantage this whole time.
Yeah.
You know? Because we don't know.
Exactly.
But apparently he knows something.
Mm-hmm. Or he's saying he knows something.
Find out eventually. On the next episode of Dragon Ball.
Yeah, I'm out the way. Yeah, I'm low, okay. Yeah. I don't want to back. Shoot. way, I'm low, okay. Yeah, the island right here is remote, okay. I ain't thinking about no reaper. Nigga, I'm reaping what I sow, okay. Got a Benjamin and a Jackson all in my house, like I'm Joe, okay. Hellcat, met his own boys in them types LA solo, okay. Everybody wanna be demon till they get chipped by your throwaway. And I might do a show a day. What's a lame? Always a lame. Oh, you thought the money, the power of fame will make you go away. Have you ever played? Have you ever? Okay, nigga, let's play. Have you ever watched your enemy down like with a poker face? Have you ever paid 500 thou like to an open case? Well, I have, and I felt that both, but I came out straight. I hate when a rapper talk about guns, then somebody die, they turn into nuns, then hop online like pray for my city. He faking for likes and digital hugs. His daddy a killer, he wanna be junior. They must have forgot the shit that they done. Dementia must run in his family, but let it get shaky. I park his son the very first time I
Oh my goodness. This man came for the family.
He said the mention must run in your family. Mike, listen to me. I know there was like 20 bars that I just did not understand. Mm-hmm. But this one, this one right here, I know you don't understand it, but mm-hmm. it's the only one that I understand. So I'm trying to explain it to you and everybody that don't understand this one line right here. This nigga said, before that, he was talking about how he faking for life, digital hugs, his daddy a killer. Mm-hmm. He wanna be junior.
Yes, I understood that.
They must have forgot the shit that they done.
Yeah.
So his daddy killing, but he not really like that.
Mm-hmm. Like he'll but he be, wanna be like
but that. He'll be,
but acting like he like that.
He's acting like he like that, but he'll really tell the police. Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm. Dimension must run in his family, but let it get shaky. I park your son. Dementia.
Oh, okay.
Illness.
Yes.
Must run in your family, but when he say mention, it's like his family, like legacy. Like he said, his daddy's a killer, but you really not. Mm-hmm. So when they say mention, they mean he's talking about the family legacy, right? That his daddy, like if you mention his daddy, he's a killer. Mm-hmm. But also when you say mention, you say salute that he's really not a killer. Drake's really not a killer. He'll tell on you. The mention must run in his family. Yo, you following me so far?
Yes, yes, yes.
But this sound like, when you say it, it sounds like you're saying dementia.
Yeah.
Which is a sickness. And he say run in his family. But let it get shaky, as in let shit beef really happen. Yeah,
get crazy.
You can see both those dynamics of his fam, like the dynamic his fam is known for, and the dynamic that he really presents. Let it get shaky.
Yeah.
I'll park your son's Parkinson's disease.
Oh,
bro. Shaky, Parkinson's. I'll park your son. That is not a part of your family legacy. For real.
How do people be thinking about this stuff when they be writing it, bro?
My head already hurts. That was a triple entendre.
That was. What?
That's a triple entendre, Mike.
And most people are going to listen to this and be like, that's hard, but they really don't know.
You really don't know. Like I said, Mike, there was like 30 bars. I just did not know what he was talking about. I got no idea what he was talking about.
Until we got here.
What made it ring for me.
Made sense.
And then I started realizing more shit as I was explaining to you. It was crazy. But all I heard was the dementia and Parkinson's. Get shaky. That's all I heard. But then I started going back. I'm like, this nigga. Whew, shit.
You wildin'.
The thing is, bro. I say this, right? And we're going to keep going because this is 6 minutes. We're 2 minutes deep. I don't like the fact that I gotta think that hard. I don't, really. But I honor the thought that it's still part of rap music.
Yeah,
to be
sure.
Able to be that lyrical, and it's just like I don't mean to cut you off, but I like it when it's easily digestible. Mm-hmm. This also entertains me, like figuring out something that like I just died, like how I was able to point it out, mm-hmm. and that part was just digestible to me, but. Going back, I seen more stuff.
For sure.
That's hard to me.
That's
because I was already hit by the punchline. Mm-hmm. But now I'm getting tag team now.
The only thing that sucks about this is that, like, people who... Well, let's say I was, like, somebody like me was listening to this, right? Mm-hmm. Maybe eventually if I listen to it a couple times.
Yeah.
But it's not going to get the appreciation it deserves from the average listener.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because they'll be like, oh, that's hard. But then, like...
You really don't know how hard it is.
You come back and be like, yeah. I'd be like, but did you listen to this? Right. Like, I'm going to go back to work tomorrow and talk to Mike and be like, bro, yeah, you know it was hard. But did you...
Do you know how hard it was?
Yeah.
You heard that line, but you feel that line.
Yeah.
Like I said, man. We going... And then it's one of those songs where... It's one of those songs where people just be coming... Going to be coming out with different shit.
Yeah.
But then that's smart because everybody going to just keep talking about it.
Facts.
Let's see if we can make it through.
30 seconds was wild.
Let's see if we can make it another 30 seconds without stopping it. This boy got me stressed out, man.
Then I hop online, like, pray for my city. He faking for likes and digital hugs. His daddy a killer, he wanna be junior. They must have forgot the shit that they done. Dementia must run in his family, but let it get shaky. I park his son. The very first time I shot me.
God damn it. It's so small, I just forgot to say it. He said, they must have forgot the shit that they done. Dementia. They must have forgot.
The shit that they've done. Oh.
Dementia. Must run.
See, that's what I'm saying. The
must
first
run
time,
in his family.
Right over.
But let it get shaky. I'll park your son. That was too.
Parkinson's.
Man. Yes, bro. My God. Damn it.
Fuck. And he was setting it up. When he said they turned into nuns. Oh, no, this is after.
Yeah, that was before.
Oh, it was before, yeah. Nuns.
Yeah, it was a place. It's like the different.
Yeah.
I don't got time for all this, bro.
The very first time I shot me a Drake, the homie had told me to aim it this way. Had been point down enough. Today I show you I learned from those mistakes. Somebody had told me that you got a ring. Oh, God, I'm ready to double the wage. I'd rather do that than let a Canadian nigga make pot turn in his grave. Cut the bitch, you got shit twisted. What is it, the brakes? I heard your finish, you don't work with me no more. Okay. There's three ghosts left, and I see two of them kissing and hugging on stage. I love them to death, and in 8 bars I'll explain their phrase.
In 8 bars I'll explain that phrase.
Jesus. I thought I heard something about goats.
Okay, there's three ghosts left, and I see two of them kissing and hugging.
These lyrics is flawed. He said it's three. He said, yet he still go left. And see, but in the song, I feel like he's clearly saying there's three ghosts left. See, listen.
Okay, there's three ghosts left, and I see two of them kissing and hugging on stage.
Oh,
I love
okay.
them to death, and in 8 bars I'll explain their phrase. It's not nobody can tell me. I don't want to talk on no celly. You know I got language barriers. It's no accent you can sell me. Your Cole and Ivory know I'm a selfish nigga. The crown is heavy. I pray they my real friends. If not, I'm YNW Melly. I don't like you popping shit.
You know YNW, man.
Yes.
You know what he did?
Yes.